Hello and welcome to Innovation Oxford. I'm your host, Michael Harding. On today's program, we're going to visit the Bertrand farm here in Norwich Township. They've been on the farm here since 1923. Folks in Norwich Township are going to remember the Pollard's Dairy, but that disappeared some time ago, bought out by Silverwoods, which ended up in Woodstock. And I'm here on the Bertrand farm with Wayne Bertrand, and he's going to talk a little bit about the equipment that they've used over the years since 1923, when Dad was on the farm here and built it up with Ayrshire breeding stock. But what we're talking about today is, in fact, the tractors that you've used, and you've got a whole collection here. Yep. So why don't you walk us through what some of this equipment has done for you, the ages, et cetera, yep. Because some of them look old to me, yeah. As a city boy. This one particularly here, tell us a little bit about that.
That's an International Cultivation A. It was built prior to the early, 1950. This model here was built in 1948. It was made specifically for farming in general. Farms weren't big, we didn't need big tractors. It had cultivators on it, it had a plow on it, and it had cultivators, and that's what the farmers wanted, and that's kind of the way it went. And from this tractor, we go to that tractor, and they're basically the same tractor, same horsepower. This has live hydraulics in it, so you didn't have to use levers to lift your equipment up and down. And this is called a Super A. It's basically was made from 1950 up to about 56, 57. And then they changed them over to the next generation of Internationals.
These are all in working conditions too, aren't they?
Yep, we run all these tractors all the time. They do our field work. Now granted, we have newer tractors to do better job or different jobs. But when we want to play around and do our farm work, we work all our bean ground up with the two tractors at the back end and a couple of old cultivators.
This tractor is in another part of your operation here. What's special about this one?
This is the first one Dad bought.
That was the first. When did he buy it?
1942.
It yep. looks like it's in very good condition.
It is. We spent probably four times its original value restoring it.
And what did he pay for it? Any idea?
That tractor and a nice bottom plow to go with it cost him $1,200.
And so today, I think you probably spent a little more than $1,200 to bring it back?
Yeah, four times that.
Aubrey.
Yes.
There's something older than both of us combined, and we're looking at it now. Tell us what this is and its family history.
Well, this is a Lister engine, and actually we bought this tractor, our engine. Well, when I was a kid, we had one exactly the same in the barn, and that's what our dad used to pump water and chop mangles. And
what's a mangle?
Well, it's something the same as a turnip, okay. But they used to grow them to feed cows.
Okay.
And they would, well, we got the old chopper in the barn, really, that they used to put them in. But back when I had a sister who was 3 years old that got her coattail caught in this
Ooh.
Thing and went around that thing.
Was she hurt?
She was hurt. They didn't figure she'd live, but she did, and it bruised her up. Oh, yeah. Broke her leg and all these
things. Oh, my heavens. Yeah, I mean, equipment was not always safe, was
Oh,
it?
No, like this thing flies around. It don't go fast, but it goes around there, and it's right out in the open. No shields or anything like back in those days. Like they.
And what does this do?
That's an ace bottom plow. That's what they use to turn the furrows over, and the plows today are the same thing, only bigger.
Do you restore this as well?
Nope. Solomon Yancey done that again.
And this has a brand name attached to it?
It's a Rockaway.
Four-seater.
Four-seater.
Pulled by how many horses?
You could put a team of light horses on there or just a single horse.
Be a little breezy in winter, wouldn't you think?
Yeah, but they have a design of these buggies that's more closed in.
What holds your interest? It's a lot of work.
History.
History?
History.
Whose history?
Just history of the country, history of farming. All of the stuff we have here, to me, is history.
What an amazing visit we've had with Wayne and Aubrey Bertrand, obviously committed to preserving the history of farm implements. And coming up, we're going to see what the future holds for another company in the same business generations later. We'll be right back after this short break.